Also tonight, Race Against Time, how rescuers battled in vain to save a schoolgirl trapped in a car that crashed into a river.
On patrol with the highwaymen, but are they succeeding in keeping our roads free of hold-ups?
Pouncing to victory, the Panthers celebrate cup success over their arch rivals.
And just look at that stony face, those chiselled looks. No, not him, him. Yes, I'll be meeting the cathedral, who's had his face immortalised as a gargoyle.
Good evening. Now, most of us have been in that very frustrating position where we've either been stuck in a traffic jam or broken down on the motorway. In the past, it meant hours of misery for other commuters, but now there's a team dedicated to keeping the traffic flowing.
In 2006, the Highways Agency set up traffic hit squads across the East Midlands to cut congestions on our motorways. Well, 2 years on, Phil Brewster went out on patrol with one of them to see how they're making a difference.
6 a.m. and patrol teams are preparing for another busy day on the roads. Traffic officers Bob Heath and David Lakin do some last-minute checks before heading out. Conditions on the M1 are bad, with thick fog and ice on the roads. Rush hour starts early on the M1, and it's not long before they come across their first job, a van which is broken down on the hard shoulder. A quick chat with the driver reveals the van's electrics have died. While a recovery truck loads up the van, Bob keeps a watchful eye on the traffic hurtling up the motorway behind them.
Our main role here is not only to protect the driver and to offer protection at the rear of the vehicle, but also to protect the recovery operator who's working at the side of the vehicle in live lanes. So we're here for him as well.
They do a good job and quite satisfied with what they've done this morning to me. I mean, they've stopped traffic coming up back on me and everything. That's a good thing.
Job done. Bob and David are on their way, but there's no time to rest as they soon get wind of another incident that needs urgent attention.
It appears to be a single vehicle has collided with the central reservation. It's currently sideways on in lane 3. The occupants of that vehicle are standing in the central reservation, a very dangerous place to be. So it's our intention to get there as quick as we can now, get the vehicle cleared from the carriageway and more importantly, get the occupants safely over onto the grass embankment.
It's a tricky situation, but Bob and David are soon operating like a well-oiled machine. Bob holds up the oncoming traffic while David hooks up a tow rope to move the car out of harm's way. With the police arriving to lend a helping hand, it's not long before the traffic is flowing once again. Keeping an overall eye on what's happening on our motorways now are staff at the Highways Agency Regional Control Centre near Nottingham. With hundreds of cameras, phones and signs at their disposal, it's their job to keep the traffic flowing freely.
We can tell the traffic officers that are going to the scene exactly what they're going to come across when they get there, what to deal with, how to sort out any diversions. We've just, you know, hopefully we're prepared for every eventuality.
But everyone can remember an incident where being prepared just wasn't enough.
What we assumed was a live lane breakdown. When we got there, we turned up, we stopped the traffic, made it safe, and it was actually a child in the back of the car choking on a sherbet lemon sweet.
A trailer that had turned over that was full of live piglets, and so many people trying to catch the piglets, but as well having to close the motorway to be able to get those. So that's the good thing with the job. You never know what's going to happen next. Every day is unique.
In total, there are 69 traffic officers patrolling the region. In the last year alone, it's estimated they travelled 770,000 miles, and in the same period, they dealt with nearly 34,000 incidents. It's all a far cry from the 1950s when the M1 was used by just a few thousand cars a day. Nowadays it's 150,000 in the East Midlands alone. And that means just one thing, traffic jams. It's estimated they cost the country £20 billion a year, so keeping the roads clear is vital. So 2 years on, have the traffic patrols made a difference?
Until that obstruction is cleared, people's journeys are going to be held up, there's going to be traffic jams, they're going to be late for meetings. You know, we get that cleared and then they can be on their way.
With traffic numbers set to rise even further, the job of keeping us all motoring can only get harder. But at least with people like Bob and David on the case, any delay should be just that little bit shorter. Phil Brewster for Central Tonight.
Interesting stuff. A good job they do too. And wouldn't it be great if the M1 was like it was 50 years ago? Fantastic.
Unlikely. Yes, that's it from us for tonight. I'm back just before 7 with a recap of the East Midlands main headlines.
Stay with us on ITV1. The national news is next. But from everyone here, thanks for watching.
Goodbye. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.